Coach Accountable Engagements allow you to track and manage the engagements you have with your clients. Specifically, this means tracking the allocation of appointments that they are entitled to, including how many they have left, getting or sending notifications about the progression of engagements, and issuing invoices for the engagement, either as a one-time payment or a scheduled sequence, like a subscription or installment plan. In this video, we're going to learn how to set up the system to manage your engagements. To get started, open the Settings menu and click on Engagements. Let's look at the basic options. These are global settings, meaning they apply across your account. The first option involves how and when clients are allowed to schedule appointments with you. You can choose Never Allowed. This means you, as coach, will always be responsible for scheduling appointments with clients. They don't get to schedule themselves. Or Allowed within the limits of an engagement. This means that a client must be in an engagement that is active in order to schedule with you. No engagement? Clients can't schedule. Or Allowed unless engagement says otherwise. This means clients can request appointments with you unless they've ever been set up in an engagement. If they have, then the rules of the engagement determine whether or not the client can schedule with you. If you plan to use engagements strictly across all of your clients, this second option is probably appropriate. If you plan to use engagements with only some of your clients, leaving others to have a more free-form working relationship with you, this third one is probably the option you'll want to choose. The next setting involves marking appointments as verified. Verified means that an appointment does count towards an engagement's allocation. This can be a handy distinction because a no-show or a too-late cancellation may or may not count towards the allocation. It all depends on your policy. Generally, automatic verification is nice because that represents business as usual, but you can choose to manually mark them all as well. Whichever you set, you can always manually adjust which appointments are and are not verified as counting. Now let's move on to engagement templates, which define the coaching packages that you offer and make it easy for you to set those packages in motion for your clients. When you're just getting started, you'll find that you can install one or more sample templates. This is a great way to explore some of the setups that are possible. We'll start fresh by clicking Plus Engagement Template. We see that the template is broken up into four parts: Basics, Rules, Notifications, and Invoicing Plan. We'll start with Basics. Give the engagement a name. Your clients are apt to see this name, so make it clear and descriptive. We'll call this one 6-month package with weekly sessions. If you have a Team Edition account, you'll have this option to set the Managing Coach. The Managing Coach is the one who will get notifications about the engagement, which we'll cover shortly. Real quick, it's worth noting that this setting, like everything else defined by a template, can be overridden when you start an actual engagement for a specific client. Next, let's set the allocation. You can choose to have this measured either by number of appointments or by the total number of appointment hours. If your appointments are all 1 hour long exactly, these methods of measuring are equivalent. But if you offer appointments that vary in their duration, measuring by hours may be more appropriate than by count of appointments. For example, we're offering 4 1-hour appointments per month, so our allocation for the 6-month is 24 appointments. Now, if we offered only 30-minute appointments, then we could set either 24 appointments or 12 hours, because 24 half-hour appointments adds up to 12 hours of appointment time. Next, duration. How long should this engagement last? Put another way, how long should the client have in order to use up their allocation? You can choose continues indefinitely if this type of engagement should go until closed out, and you'll likely want to choose this if you're doing a month-to-month subscription, wherein your clients are allowed to continue renewing. In our example, it's a 6-month package, so 6 months is appropriate. You'll notice that this is already set. In fact, if Coach Accountable can guess the duration based on the name of the template, it will fill it right in for you. Finally, you can set the client visibility for engagements of this template. This gives you the option to make the details of a client's engagement visible to that client, including how far they've progressed through the allocation and, if suitable, details about the invoicing tied to it. Now, let's look at rules. Our first set of rules concern applicability, rules for defining which appointments should actually be counted toward the allocation. Counting appointments based on them having certain duration can be handy. Say you offer a free 15-minute checking calls to your clients. These appointments shouldn't count toward the allocation. To achieve that, set this to only count appointments that are at least 16 minutes at the low end, thus leaving those appointments that are 15 minutes or less as not counting. Next, indicate whether group appointments count or not. If it's an all-group participation program, these group appointments probably should count. And conversely, if someone signed up for a one-on-one coaching but are also invited to attend group sessions, it might be that those group appointments should not count. Finally, you can carve out more specific exceptions or inclusions based on the appointment's name. By default, there is no further filtering out. But, for example, you can count only appointments called weekly call and monthly call, so that your mastermind call appointments don't count. Or you can count only appointments without a certain name. Maybe everything that has the word free in it is, well, free. Partial matches count, so if we type free here, our free intro call and free check-in appointments will not be counted. Let's move on to notifications. There are three flavors of engagement notifications that you can set. The first is based on progress through the engagement allocation. This will notify you or your client when there are only a certain number of appointments left in the engagement. The second is a time-based notification. This will notify you or your client when the engagement is now a certain number of days in. The third will notify you or your client when it's been a certain number of days since the last appointment, specifically when there's still nothing else scheduled on the calendar. Setting this serves to alert you or your client when things are ostensibly stalled out in your coaching relationship and prompt scheduling of the next session. You can use this to keep the momentum in those coaching relationships going. Let's set one of each of these types. The first one will notify the client toward the tail end of their engagement. Let's say notify client when verified appointments get to within 2 of the allocation via email. The second one will let the coach know that there's only a week left. Let's say notify coach on day 173 via email. Note the system calculated a few handy options based on our overall duration. 6 months is 180 days, so 1 week shy of that, 173. Now let's make sure that we've got some good schedule nudges. Say that we want clients to generally be in the habit of scheduling their next appointment within a few days of the last one. So, notify client if it's been 3 days since the last appointment via email. And if things are really getting behind, we'll set one for ourselves a few days after that. Notify coach if it's been 7 days. That way, we can personally intervene if that little reminder didn't do the trick. The emails for these progress notifications can entail a lot of detail about the engagement, but the gist, for example of this one, could be to the effect of, "Hey, we only have 2 more sessions left. I hope it's going well so far. Let me know if you want to book another package." You can see and customize the exact language used in these engagement notifications. Do so in Settings, System, Message Templates, under these 2 templates, Engagement Progress Notification and Engagement Schedule Nudge Notification. If you're on Team Edition, notifications that are set to send to Coach will be sent to the Managing Coach as we set earlier. Otherwise, if you're on a basic account, they'll naturally be sent to you. Finally, the invoicing plan. Here's where we can set up recurring invoices, which will automatically be sent and, potentially, automatically paid. You can choose to skip invoicing altogether if, say, the client will have already paid some other way. You can choose to send 1 invoice, or you can choose to have the system send a series of invoices, spread out over time. For example, let's say this engagement entails a routine invoice, 1 per month, until the engagement is over. If we do a series of invoices, we can have the allocation update itself automatically upon payment of a routine invoice. That's nice if you want to, for instance, have clients be able to schedule only the 4 appointments they've paid for in a particular month. Then, upon paying for the next month, they'll be allowed to schedule another 4. Let's revise our setup to have this. We'll set our allocation to 4 because that's what's going to be our initial allocation for the first month. And now we'll say that every time they pay their monthly invoice, our clients should be allowed an additional 4 appointments. This option allows rollover of unused appointments, and this one does not. Here we can decide whether the first invoice should go out immediately or with a delay. This is nice if, say, you have clients pay a deposit upfront, some other way, that would cover the first portion of their program. Finally, we'll create exactly what should be on the invoices. Here's where you can add any taxes, processing fees, and so forth. And you set when these invoices should be due. Invoices that come from this engagement can either be due immediately or some number of days later. We'll save this template, and now, with it, we're ready to start clients on this type of engagement with just a few clicks. At this point, you can create a template for each type of program that you offer. It may well be that you have only one, but you might find, as you go, others that are worth defining and making available. The final thing I want to show you is this report on current engagements. You won't see much of anything on this when you're starting out, but when you've got some clients enrolled and participating in your programs, you'll see here a nice at-a-glance listing of where they're all at in their engagements with you. And that's it! We've now covered how to set the basic options around your engagements, and how to define various types of engagements you might offer, including allocation and duration, rules for which appointments apply, notifications that should be sent, and the invoicing plan. With that, you're ready to put your clients into these engagements to have Coach Accountable start managing the details.